Not sure which thumbnail to use? Try Test and Compare, a feature that lets you choose up to 3 video thumbnails to test with viewers to help pick your winner. Here's how it works. Eligible creators can use the Test and Compare feature through YouTube Studio Desktop when publishing a new video or with an existing video. On the video details page, go to Thumbnail. From the options, select Test and Compare. From here, you can upload up to 3 images to learn which one viewers prefer, then click Done. Testing is only available for public, long-form videos, and the test will start once you publish your video. Here's how the test works. YouTube will show your chosen thumbnails evenly across your video's audience and will select a winning thumbnail based on which one generates the most watch time share. You can check the status of your test at any time by going to the video details page and clicking View Test Report. From here, you'll see how much time is left for the test and how they're performing. You can also choose to stop the test and manually set one of the thumbnails as the winner. If you let the test run, the results may take a few hours or up to a couple weeks to be finalized. How long it takes to get the result is affected by factors like how similar your thumbnails are. The more they differ, the more likely your test will finish faster. And your video traffic. The more thumbnail impressions that your video receives, the faster your test will finish. Once the test is finished, the test report will show the results. If there's a statistically significant result, you'll see a winner label. YouTube will automatically update your video thumbnail to this winner when the test is done. You might also see a preferred label, which means the results were not statistically significant, but there was a thumbnail that performed slightly better. If there's no clear winner, the first thumbnail will be selected and shown to your audience. Remember that in either case, it's ultimately up to you. You can always manually select the video thumbnail you want to use. You can also choose to run a new test, but note, it will delete your old experiment. Let's walk through some things to note and best practices for using the Test and Compare feature. Thumbnails must follow our community guidelines, and the tool will not work on videos that are designated as made for kids, for mature audiences, or live. Note that great thumbnails serve an important purpose beyond getting viewers to click. They help a viewer understand what the video is about so that they don't waste their time clicking on the wrong videos. We suggest testing thumbnails on a limited selection of older videos for initial guidance, then a selection of more recent videos you think will provide the most meaningful insights for your content strategy. We also recommend testing thumbnail variations that explore different layout compositions and changes to thumbnail elements, including background, text overlays, and object placement, to learn which resonates most with your audience. Some tips to keep in mind. Ensure your images are balanced, with a focal point to direct viewers' attention towards. Utilize high contrast, allowing your subject to stand out against the background in both light and dark mode. If there's a face in your thumbnail, consider emotion. Be expressive and consider how you want viewers to feel when seeing your thumbnail. With text, remember that fewer words can be impactful, while too much text can be difficult to process while scrolling. And finally, when it comes to depth of field, keep your background in mind and play with blank space. We hope the Test and Compare feature will help you gain insights when it comes to making thumbnails and help your overall video performance in the long run. For more info, check out the links below. Thanks for watching.